We're here at the historical Bastard Ranch where we've recorded so many records, and it's also Keith's home.
It is.
And this is where we did our latest effort. So come on in.
We'll give you a tour. We did this entire record on this API 1608 console, Adams speakers, Patanoi big speakers for when we want to get really loud, and as you can see, we have a collection of vintage amps and outboard gear. There are many guitars that go into the recording that obviously are not here today. Well, since we're on the road right now, back and forth so much, I tried to not keep as many of the valuable guitars in the studio while we're not here. Of course, as many people know, there are many Midas guitars that get used on every record, so it's just a few of the guitars that are left hanging around. ...1973 Marshall Super Lead, last of the point-to-point hand-wired amplifiers, on pretty much every record. 1968 Marshall Super Bass. 1966 or 67, I can't remember which year, JTM 45, original amp. Marshall Super Jubilee, the 1968 small box 50-watt Marshall, a Naylor Super Drive 60 on the bottom. Every kid needs one of those. What do we got in the way of pedals? A vintage Vox Wah-Wah. So that's a vintage MXR script logo. Phase 45. Pretty much the best overdrive ever created. This is the original Klon Centaur. First version, very collectible, and collectible for good reason, because it sounds fantastic. An old, I'm not sure which year, Sound City 50 Plus. Phenomenal amp. Early 70s high watt. This amp is the sound of the All Night Long record. That's pretty much every track on that record has been through that amp. This Park amplifier here, this amplifier was featured heavily on the first two Buckcherry records, the self-titled record and the Time Bomb record, and a Wizard classic, which if you want to sound like AC/DC, you plug into that head and there's the answer right there, and a vintage 20-watt Marshall head below that. So most of the songs on this record were recorded through an Atari MTR 90 2-inch tape machine. So this was used heavily. And then of course the API console that we picked up. I picked this up a few years back. A lot of people don't know, they always wonder why this CD is on the console. That's actually Jimmy Page's autograph. He wrote me a note after our first record, and he heard the record and he signed it to me and sent it over. Always nice to hear from Mr. Page. And that's kind of the quick tour of the studio. And that's it.